A week out of lockdown and now it's time to book a holiday. The state government helping to foot the bill. $50 vouchers will be given to every adult to spend on accommodation within the state.
The Premier was poolside today, splashing more cash to put everyone in the holiday mood.
This over $500 million investment today will see tourism in New South Wales, as I said, not just bounce back but fly back right across the state.
The Dine and Discover voucher will be rebranded to Stay and Rediscover, $50 for every person over 18 to spend on accommodation.
We know this works.
It has hotel operators like Simon McGrath rubbing their hands after reaping the rewards in the first week out of lockdown.
Even without the interstate borders open, we've seen a 20 to 25% increase in bookings.
It's that pre-Christmas rush which has the government holding back on releasing the accommodation vouchers for the moment. The plan is to roll them out in March in an attempt to extend the holiday season.
There's also $60 million to woo back international airlines to Sydney, with the offer to pay for empty seats and share a marketing campaign with the state government.
We've got to get back into the market and we've got to say to those international airlines, bring those flights back to Sydney.
And there were flights out of Sydney to Melbourne, today worth noting, for the first time in a long time. No need to quarantine for 14 days.
We've had our negative tests, we're vaccinated and ready to give our family a big hug.
Don't have to quarantine for 2 weeks, fantastic.
I'm actually going to Warrnambool, regional Victoria. Allowed to go to regional Victoria but not regional New South Wales, so it doesn't make much sense to me.
And after spruiking the new travel vouchers, the tourism minister later jumped on the Matildas bandwagon, confirming new crowd limits for two upcoming games against Brazil at Bankwest Stadium.
The crowd will be able to have 75% of the venue, so we're expecting as much as 20,000 people.
600 tickets will be handed out to frontline workers as a thank you. Damien Ryan, Nine News.
New South Wales has now gone 3 days with cases below the 300 mark. 283 new infections today. In another positive sign, hospital admissions due to COVID-19 are also dropping. 552 patients right now receiving treatment. 124 people are in ICU. Sadly, 7 people died. 5 of them were not fully vaccinated. With so many people fully vaccinated, New South Wales Health has refined the definition of close contact. Sophie Walsh is with me in the studio. Sophie, how have the rules changed?
Well, Pete, with close contacts, they'll generally be within your household. Sometimes it'll be people you spend a lot of time with socialising indoors, so friends and partners. And occasionally we'll see close contacts in workplaces, but not often because of COVID-safe measures like social distancing. If someone tests positive in your home, you only need to isolate for 7 days if you are fully vaccinated. But once released, you have to work from home where possible and not visit cafes, restaurants or high-risk settings like hospitals, aged care facilities and schools for 7 days. If you've only had one dose or no doses, you still have to isolate for the full 14 days. Interestingly, if you've already had COVID-19 in the past 6 months, you don't need to self-isolate or get tested at all unless you have symptoms. If someone at your child's school or daycare centre tests positive, the facility will provide advice. If your child is deemed a close contact but is fully vaccinated, they'll need to self-isolate for 7 days from the day they came into contact with the infected person. If they're not double dosed, they'll need to isolate for 14 days and so will at least one parent. As for businesses, they don't necessarily have to close if a worker tests positive, but the venue does need to be cleaned, which can happen overnight without disrupting trade. Pete.
Sophie, thank you.